Good morning, guys. Oh boy, we're out here checking water traps today. As you can hear, we're right by a road. Leave this guy up here for now. Here we got a number 11 guarding a hole. Sorry if it's super loud right now, but then right here we got a number 2 guarding the hole. Sort of foamed in. We got a little bit of bait or whatever in the back. I might just spruce up these sets with a little bit of whatever, but other than that, we're gonna be in and out. So I'll see you guys at the next spot. There goes a fox. I don't know if I got it. You guys might have been able to see it. Next culvert we got here. Hopefully we got something. I'm not sure how well you guys can see, but there's a 110 there. We'll sort of just clean off. Here we go. Just taking a stick and cleaning off and around the trigger. And if we get snapped, it's not on my hand, it's on the stick. There we go. Just got a couple killer clips. This is wood right here. Just got a couple killer clips with those traps right on them. There goes a piece of weed that just clogged up my set. But anyway, then we got it wired off to this fence staple here, which somebody conveniently put there for me. Same deal on this side, so. All right, leave these sets. Move on to the next spot. Okay, guys, here we got another culvert. This spot produced a muskrat for me yesterday. I didn't film it, but we got a nice rat here yesterday, so hopefully we got a mink or a rat here again today. The spot seemed pretty good whenever I checked it out in the summer, so hopefully it's decent right now. So first thing, we got 110 here, nothing there. Oh, we got something. I think we got a mink here. Oh no, is that a rat? I can't tell. Take him out. Yeah, there we go, another rat. I'll get you, 1 second, I know you guys can't see this very well. We're gonna have to get another piece of apple here. I'm not sure how well you guys can see, but this is the same set that produced really well for me yesterday. I caught a rat in here yesterday. We got another one here today. So I'll get this guy out in the light for you guys to see. Look at that, just a nice rat. You know, this is my second rat. I don't know too much about muskrats, but he's a nice little guy. This culvert's quite interesting, really. So anyway, I got a 110 there, got a foothold here, then I got a 160 up here. You got anything? I don't think we have anything. Sure is, we got weeds though. We got plenty of weeds. Anyway, I'll go back, grab the headlamp, and we'll get that set remade. Alright, so this trap is a Victor 1.5 long spring on a drowned wire here. So, like I said, all that was here was just some apple. So we'll chuck a couple pieces of apple there. Just wash this off. Like I said, this is a Victor 1.5. We'll just compress the spring on it. We'll fold the jaws out there with the dog up over the jaw. Pop that pan into place. Hold it under with my fingers, so when I do let go of my right hand, it won't go off on me. Just like that. The water level started changing here a little bit. Past couple days, it's come out quite a bit, so. So we can move some of the sand out of the way, I guess, is what we'll have to do to get that trap to lay in there. Pull some of that more of that sand out of there. Get that trap to lay nice underwater. Just like that's probably good. I got my tag on my trap here, still there. I'd be pretty surprised if a muskrat pulls the tag out, but anyway. There we go. Just like so. Wash your hands off in the water. We got some apples and some carrots on there. And that set's ready again to go for tonight. Or even today, hopefully get another rat. Wash my waders off in here. Now this set is full of weeds, so we're gonna have to get the weeds out of there somehow. I think I'm gonna take this out. Reese, we'll sort of make this a little bit of a different set there. Gotta pull some of that weed stuff out. You can get some off the top, but Just like dappy, very gingerly. So this is, I guess, sort of like a bottom edge set, I guess. This is actually not a 110, this is a 2. This is a 120, my bad. If you guys are enjoying what you're seeing, make sure to hit that like button, I guess. And subscribe, that would be awesome if you guys subscribe. But anyway, enough plugging myself and trying to get subs. We'll just keep on with the video. These guys don't like this. There goes a couple little trout. Anyway, we'll grab a stone like this. Sort of set that like there, I guess. Yeah, that should be good. And then I'll grab this twig right here. I'm gonna shove that twig right in there. There we go. It'll sort of act like a dive stick too if they're up, I guess. That looks pretty good. I'm not sure if you guys can see, but it's snowing. So beautiful. All right, guys, we're coming up on another culvert here. One trap's still there. That trap's still there. So here's one set here. Got it on a drowner that goes down there. There's a stick in the way. Got this guy baited up with a carrot. Got basically the same set over here. This guy's baited up with an apple. We haven't had any luck here, so. I mean, not yet. I gotta be patient. Yeah, just a couple bridge and one and a half sitting there. But yeah, nothing in here. We'll move on to the next culvert, I guess. We are at the next spot. Oh, our trap's gone. Okay, so we'll start off with this set. We just have a 120 into there. We had a 1.5 here. I'm not sure if the water just pushed it off or if we actually have something. Yeah, our apple's gone. Oh, we got some. We got another muskrat. Here we go. Set that guy right there.
Trying to figure out how he got himself on here. Trying to figure out how to pull this back up.
Oh, there we go. I'll go get some more bait. We'll get this set remade here. Yeah, look at that. Look at that beauty rat there. That is nice. All right, here we go. We got a slice of apple. Oh, that didn't work very well. Get a couple pieces of apple on this stick here. Shove that right there. And we'll get another. We'll get another stick. Something like that. Chuck this apple down there. Try to shove it down in there. There we go. So we got some bait there. We got some bait back there. I don't know if you guys can see, but there's some mink feces right here. So I don't know. We got a good chance of catching a mink while he's working through here. But find a drowner. Make sure everything's not kinked up or anything. This one's pretty good. So I'm thinking yesterday the water level was higher, but I'm thinking today we're going to be able to take that stone off. So reset the trap, just like that. There we go. Pull that pound down a little bit. This guy's managed to work himself down the drowner. I love these drowners, these work so well. Gonna get our trap sort of like that. I think right there's pretty good. So that muskrat swims up here. He'll come up here and feed on this and whatever. He'll jump back down here. We may catch him there. He might just be coming through here, put his paw on that. Get that stuff in the back. But I think this set's pretty good. So hopefully we get another one here in the morning or even a mink. A mink would be nice, but. Alrighty. Hopefully get another one tomorrow. Alright guys, so that's it. Thank you guys so much for coming along today, checking the line. We did manage to pick up 2 rats, as you guys saw. Got one of them right here. Actually, I got both of them right here, but they're really nice rats. I mean, I don't know too much about muskrats. This is my first year trapping, but they look pretty good. But anyway, we caught these guys both in 1.5 Victor long spring, so those are one heck of a trap. But anyway, before I go, I want to say please check out my sponsors, Dan Beaver Trapping Supplies. They got some really nice products there. Please make sure to check those guys out. And Duke Traps and Long Creek Trapping Supplies, please make sure to check those both out as well. But anyway, other than that, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please stay tuned for more videos. Hopefully we'll make another one tomorrow. Hopefully we catch a couple more things tomorrow. But yeah, if you guys did enjoy the video, please make sure to like, subscribe, and comment. I would really appreciate all those things. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll talk to you in the next. See you then.